How's it going, guys? Welcome back to another video. Now, in this video, I'm going to be going over the top ways I think Respawn can improve on Fallen Order. So these are just a couple ideas I have. If they're going to continue to update the game and listen to feedback, like, so far we haven't heard anything about their plans to, like, to change this game in the future. We don't know if they're going with, like, a live service approach. We don't know if there's going to be any story DLC. I mean, we know there's not going to be any microtransactions, but going forward, what are they going to do with this game? Are they just going to leave it and not do any updates at all? That's a possibility. But if they are going to continue supporting this game and they are going to do updates, then these are my ideas for how I think they could make the game better. Some of the stuff might apply to a second game. Like, if they just make a Jedi Fallen Order 2 in the future, then maybe they can take these ideas and just apply it to that game instead. But to start us off, my first idea is just fast travel. I've said this a number of times in previous videos, and I've seen a lot of people try to defend it and say that it doesn't need a fast travel. But if you play the game, like, late game, like, let's say you beat the whole story and you're going through and you're just trying to find nothing but the collectibles, it gets really tedious. Like, the second, third, fourth time you're going through, like, let's say you go all the way through Kashyyyk and then you realize, oh no, I missed a chest or a secret all the way at the end, and you want to get that final collectible. Well, you have to travel all the way there and all the way back, and you fight the same enemies in the same places. I mean, once you've done it so many times, it gets old. It's just repetitive. So they don't need to have fast travel from everywhere. You don't need to fast travel to every single meditation point, but at least give you an option to return to Mantis, where it just returns you straight back home. Now, there is a way around this. This game kind of already has a, like, fast travel feature kind of hidden in the game, and it's wherever you meditate last is where you respawn. So what I do is I just don't meditate. When I was going through and I was trying to find the collectibles, I would just run through the map on, like, one of the lower difficulties so I don't worry about dying, find whatever collectible I wanted, and then after I was done traveling, I would just kill myself or stand in front of an enemy and let them kill me. Then when I respawned, I would lose my current XP and stuff, which kind of sucks, but it's worth it because it would just respawn me clear back at the ship. Then I wouldn't have to run through the entire map again. So it's not like it would be hard for them to implement a fast travel system if kind of already has it in the game. It just respawns you wherever you meditated last. That's how I kind of created my own fast travel system, but it would be nice if I didn't have to kill myself. Plus, those people that are defending it, they don't have to use it. At least have the option there to return to your Mantis. That's all I'm asking for. I think that would be a big improvement. And then next up, if they're going to have any future DLC or anything, I think they should have a Horde mode. I've talked about this also in a few videos. I've seen this pop up on Reddit and stuff. People want to continue to play this game. Instead of just starting the game over fresh, brand new, and having, like, losing all your stuff, let us play the game afterwards. Because towards the end of the game, you unlock some of those final saber abilities, and you unlock all the saber colors, and you unlock all your force powers, but you, like, hardly get to use them at all at that point in the game. You get to use them for, like, maybe an hour extra after you get all the colors. So give us a Horde mode. Give us, like, two different arenas. Give us the, like, Empire Dojo kind of deal that they had in the story. Give us something like that, but make it, like, different waves. Wave 1, you face stormtroopers. Wave 10, you face, like, a boss. Same thing with, like, the Bounty Hunter arena that was in the game. Just send wave after wave of different types of enemies. You could have creatures, bounty hunters, you name it. There's definitely enough characters for them to play around in the game with. They could easily have a Horde mode, and they could tie rewards into it too. Which is kind of getting into my next thing, is they need to add more customization options. Right now, just having ponchos is kind of stupid. And that's one of the things I liked about The Force Unleashed, was because they had so many different costumes. Like, not only did it change your character's outfit, but you could play as completely different characters just for the fun of it. Like, once you beat the game, you can unlock that kind of stuff. Like, it's not going to be breaking the lore if you already beat the game. Like, let's say you beat the game, maybe you can have the option to play as Qui-Gon, or Darth Maul, or Darth Vader, or just any character you want, Mace Windu. Like, in The Force Unleashed, that's one of the things I like to do, was go back and play as Darth Maul, or play as Obi-Wan Kenobi, or just play as these different characters, That way I could just replay the story again, but I would look different. And that alone is a big change, and they just need to have some sort of new customization options. They don't have to particularly add costumes, but maybe give us different hoods or Jedi robes or just different outfits for Cal to make him look more interesting. Let me put my hood up. Just let me do some different variations instead of just pink poncho, yellow poncho, gray poncho, blue poncho. It's just really stupid just to wear nothing but ponchos. So I think that would go really well together. Let's say if you beat a certain amount of waves in Horde, you unlock a different outfit or you unlock new saber components. There's definitely room for more content that they could add to this game. But moving on from Horde and customization stuff, I think they should give us a new Game Plus mode. A lot of people requested that. Respawn said that they didn't think it would really work that well, but I say screw it. Let us have that new Game Plus. If they're so worried about it being too easy and like having all the Force powers unlocked in the early stages of the game and you're just blowing through everything, I mean, you could either A, crank up the difficulty on the hardest level. I don't know if that would make a difference or not. And if they're that concerned about it, just let us do a new Game Plus, at least with all the cosmetics. Like, let me play the game again, but I have all my ponchos, all the BD1 skins, all the different saber colors. Because right now, you don't even unlock all the cool saber colors until the end of the game. And then at that point, you don't even get to do much with it. Like, I'd love to restart the game and have, like, the coolest looking poncho that I discovered and, like, the purple color lightsaber, because I love the color purple in this game. I think that's the best looking saber, in my opinion, and I'd like to play through the story again using a purple lightsaber. So they can do New Game Plus, just make it cosmetic only. And then they could always do some story mode DLC. They don't exactly have to tie it in with Cal. They could do something with the Inquisitors. Maybe there's like a story DLC where you just play as an Inquisitor and you go around killing Jedi, or you play as one of the Inquisitors and you're like hunting down Cal, or you're like following him around to get like a different perspective of things. Like, there's different options they could do with story mode DLC. Give extra stuff for Cal, like after the story's complete. Maybe not progress the plot too much in case they want to make a second game, but there's always more stuff you could do with him. Maybe they add another planet and there's like some other adventure. Maybe there's like another Jedi temple you have to explore that they discovered. Like, there's a bunch of different options. And I'm willing to bet that even if it was paid, people would be willing to spend that extra money for some sort of story mode DLC. And then the final point that I would like to make that I think would make a huge difference is letting the bosses respawn. Like, if they're not going to add a Horde mode and they're not going to let you do New Game Plus and all you can do is free roam, at least let the bosses respawn. That doesn't really make sense with lore, but neither does meditating and respawning enemies. I don't think it'd be that big of a problem. If I want to go back and refight an AT-ST, I should be able to. If I want to go back and replay the final mission, let me. If I want to go back and fight any of the previous boss fights, I know where they're located on the map. Just let me go there and relive that boss fight. Some of the bosses are really cool, and it just kind of sucks that you can't go back and select individual missions to replay. And then once you kill the boss, they're kind of one and done. But every other enemy that isn't a boss, you can kill as many times as you like. I went through, progressed all my skill points. I have all these different combo moves and all these different abilities and stuff, but I can't really use them. Like, just let me go back and experience the boss fight using different abilities that I unlock later in the game. And then I could just go back and do that as many times as I want. I could experiment, I could try different combos, I could try different moves, I could just have fun, and that would give you a little bit more extra to do. Because once you beat the game, you find all the collectibles, that's it. Nothing you can do except for roam around aimlessly and just kill stormtroopers. And I've already gotten really tired of that. Like, I've tried to just explore and kill stuff. So I think if they let you respawn the boss fights, that would go a long way. But those are some of my ideas on what I think Respawn could do to make the game a better experience going forward. What do you guys think? Do you guys like these ideas? Let me know if you guys have any ideas of your own. Or is the game just 100% perfect and it doesn't need changed at all, and then I should just be happy with it being a one and done game? Because I've seen people use that argument as well. Regardless, let me know what you guys think. Give this video a thumbs up or a thumbs down depending on if you enjoyed it or not. Subscribe if you haven't already. Be sure to check out another video, and I will talk to you all next time.
We would be honored if you would join us. You cannot resist.